Welcome back, everyone. So here's the story. This past fall, we went to Outer Bike Moab for 3 days, Friday through Sunday, and we had planned to fly back from Denver on Monday, but we got stuck in Utah due to Winter Storm Maiden. And when life gives you lemons, well, you make lemonade, right? So we woke up early and drove to Moab Cyclery with all our gear in hopes of renting some bikes and being able to get on a shuttle to the La Salle Mountains. Objective, the Whole Enchilada. The guys at Moab Cyclery were awesome. They hooked us up with some great bikes. I got a Santa Cruz Nomad with 160 millimeters of travel, just plenty of suspension, and a solid Maxxis Minion DHF tire setup. He told us it'd take us as high as possible as it had been snowing in the mountains, and that was Sans Flats Road. Being South Florida boys, we got a bit surprised when we saw the amount of snow at the drop-off point, or at least I was. But what the heck, we all signed up for an adventure and actually wanted to do the whole enchilada, not half. The beauty of the snowy and rocky scenery was just breathtaking. We rode up Sans Flats Road with plenty of snow and then we started to go down Porcupine Rim. The ride starts with a long descent on a 4x4 road that is bone jarring, teeth rattling, you name it. The ride has some amazing places to take pictures. You have the La Salle Mountains, the edge of Castle Valley, and later on Jackass Canyon, and the Colorado River. Beautiful sceneries. Really, pictures don't do this place justice. From this point on, it's pretty much 3,000 feet of sweet descent from 6,800 feet to 4,000 feet. It's tough to figure out where the trail is at times, so watch out. You can end up in a cliff instead of a drop. This is truly the bucket list item. one of the most amazing rides that I've ever done. You gotta do it at least once in your life. We all ended up convinced that we must come back to do the Whole Enchilada sometime in the future. So, some things I learned on this trip. First of all, I learned that a dead cat is not really a dead cat. This is a windy ride, so if you plan to bring your GoPro, make sure you have a dead cat on your microphone for wind noise cancellation. I didn't, and I had to end up spending lots of time editing audio to remove noise, and it's never quite the same. Another tip, the ride, even Porcupine Rim only, is long, so take enough water and food for a full day ride just in case. Point where the view opens up 360 degrees and eventually the double track turns into a single track and the ride gets faster, more technical, and has more exposure. But we'll leave that for the next video. For now, thank you very much for watching and see you next time.